Well, you saw my early look at this game. I talked about a little bit of my time with the demo, but the collector edition is now here in my kitchen, and we are going to talk about it and open it up together. I cannot wait to play through this game. I could just tell it's going to be a special one to me. So this is exactly how it comes. The game is completely standalone. It was loose in the box. And I don't want to say loose like flopping around, because that's not the case. It wasn't loose like flopping around. It was just not part of this box. So I got it shipped. I bought it directly from the Square Enix store. As far as I know, the only way to get this was via the Square Enix store. I could be wrong on that, but I bought it from Square Enix direct. And while they did ship it like a week ago, it basically sat in Vegas for 3 or 4 days waiting for them to basically like get it to me, which is a little frustrating. I was opening this up to see if there was any like little codes or anything. They do have the reversible jacket if you want, which is kind of cool. So if you don't want to have the traditional kind of PlayStation 5 banner with some of the other like nonsense, you can go ahead and replace the jacket, which is cool. But nothing else exciting inside. They basically sat on it in Vegas for a few days, which is kind of interesting. I was hoping maybe I would get it early. That did not happen, which is fine. Of course, the reviews have come out. If you bought it digitally, you're probably well into it. I've already seen people streaming and playing through it. But I really wanted this collector edition, so I didn't mind waiting. So it is now here. I've beaten Final Fantasy VII, so my calendar is open this weekend to dive into this game and to get lost in the universe, which is exactly what I'm going to do as soon as I get this video uploaded and out. Comes with a really heavy piece of plastic here that has the label on it, Visions of Mana Collector's Edition Goods Box. And it says it was, contents were assembled in Japan, although a lot of it was made in China. So there you have the front of the box. You got the hero Val on the front. It says Visions of Mana on the side. And then on the back, you have all the heroes here together. In an ensemble with Visions of Mana. I do want to point out the box is slightly damaged here on the top. The sleeve that comes off looks fine. I used to display boxes, if you remember my old iterations of the Man Cave. I used to display boxes. I don't do that anymore. So I don't really care if the box is damaged too much. I just don't want the contents to be damaged. Here you have a cute little Moogle on one side. And then on the back, you have a really nice key art here of the heroes here looking at the mana tree. This is a really cool thing. I like that a lot. So let's figure out how to open this sucker. It's a box in a box in a box in a box. That's usually how these things work. Okay, I got it here. There's a tab here on the Visions of Mana side, and we're going to open it up together, and we're going to experience the excitement together for the first time. And there you have the inside of the box. So go ahead and move this over here and put this here to kind of hold it down. First and foremost, we have a plushie. And the plushie is of the beast. Does it say anything on it? It says Visions of Mana. And inside is a bunch of Japanese I can't read. And on the back, it says Visions of Mana Plush Ramako. And I'm assuming that's the little beast's name. I remember we had Flamey in the first one, and Flamey was awesome, and you rode Flamey around. Cool little plush, little wings, got a little tuft of hair, little twofers. I mean, I didn't buy it for the plush, but that's cool, I guess. What else do we have? We have a box here. This is the original soundtrack. I gotta say, as I'm opening this up, the plastic is super thick. They did a really good job wrapping this. Obviously, I know the box is bent, so you're probably going to say, well, geez, how good of a job did they do if the box is bent? And I think that's a fair criticism. Although the box did have those heavy-duty cellophane corner protectors, but for some reason, the top still got a little bit of damage on it, like something laid on top of it or something. Standing here looking at this, actually right here, I can see some seams down on the side of the Visions of Mana box. But again, I don't display boxes. I don't care. And the contents look fine, so I am okay with that. Heavy duty plastic, and inside you have Visions of Mana original soundtrack collector's edition special box with all the heroes on the back. And we have 3 discs worth of music to listen to. One is a standalone disc here inside called the Arrange Tracks. And inside is a list of, you're probably gonna see the reflection of the camera. Does it even show anything we're showing? Not really. It says Arrange Tracks. Does it even tell you the tracks? It does on the back. There are 5 tracks on this particular disc on the back. We got a piano arrangement, a guitar arrangement, a marimba arrangement, and then a harp arrangement as part of the Square Enix music label. That's really cool. And then over here you have the Visions of Mana original soundtrack, and here you have a lot more. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 discs. All of the discs' titles are in Japanese, which is going to be a little frustrating to figure out exactly what... does it say on the disc? I'm looking at the discs. No, that's going to be a little difficult to figure out the names in English. But thankfully, they do have a little cheat sheet book here, which includes the track list. And inside in here, it does... We'll just hold up one so you can see. It does actually show the English name next to the Chinese name, with or the Japanese name, rather, with the composer and the arrangement. So we do have the actual track list name here, which is nice. It's going to be hard to tell at a glance. I have a feeling, well, I don't know actually when I put it in my, I don't have a vehicle anymore that has a CD player, so I can't even tell you what that's gonna show, but hopefully it shows when I download them and rip them to my phone. I'm hoping it shows the English name and not all the question marks like most of my MP3s show me now when I try to listen to some of the OC remix stuff in my car. But either way, I'm excited. We'll work through that together. I just wanted to have the music to accompany the game. As I mentioned in a previous video that I did, the music means a lot to me, and it's very, very like emotional to me to even think about some of those soundtracks that I heard in the original Secret of Mana. And the little bit that I heard through the demo, I liked it. I wouldn't say that resonated with me as much as some of the early stuff I heard in the Visions of Mana, or in the Secret of Mana soundtrack, but I'm excited nonetheless. Here you have a really heavy-duty art book here, the Visions of Mana, Art of Mana Special Edition, with the key art, the Visions of Mana on the back. And then inside is the Special Edition art book with tons and tons and tons of pages of art. Character models, locations, some of the enemies you're going to encounter, some of the locations. Very, very, very heavy card stock here. Very heavy. Trying to just flip through that. I mean, these are like massively thick pieces of cardboard. I know it doesn't come off in the video, but this is like postcard thickness. Like, these are hard to bend, honestly. I typically don't love art books, as I've said in my other videos before, because, you know, the reality is a lot of times with art books, they're not that great. Oh, that's cute. All the characters are on the front. I just noticed. And I'll save the art book for the end, because I don't want to give anything away. And yeah, so we got the game, we got the art book, we got the stuffed animal, we got the soundtrack. All I really wanted was a soundtrack. That's a bonus. Maybe I can try to draw something off of that. I'll put this on the dash of my Bronco maybe, so people can tell that I'm a Visions of Mana super fan, and I'm happy with that. I don't remember what this cost. I don't remember if it was a good value or not. I quit rating these long ago, so on a scale from 1 to 10, I'm just excited to play it. And I can't wait to dive into it. So that'll wrap up the first look at the collector's edition unboxing. And yeah, as I get more into the game, expect further videos from me talking about stuff, and we'll see where this goes. That'll wrap up today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Take care of yourselves, and until next time, I will see you guys on the other side. Bye-bye.